everyone. If you have ever wondered what truly defines the role of an MSL, you are in the right place. Today, you will hear everything about it from A to Z. Because if you ask 10 people in the pharmaceutical industry, you might hear 10 slightly different answers. Some will tell you it's about engaging with key opinion leaders. Others will say it's about scientific education or supporting clinical trials. Some will tell you it's all about giving trainings to others, and few might describe it as a bridge between science and strategy. The truth is they are all right, but each of these definitions captures only part of what the MSL role really is. So let's go beyond the definitions and break down the roles and responsibilities of the MSLs, what they do, why the role is critical in modern pharmaceutical organizations, and what skills make those MSLs successful. The objective is that by the end of this session, you will be able to understand the five main categories of the roles and responsibilities of MSLs and also the purpose behind them. Let's start with the core purpose of the MSL role, which is to connect science and clinical practice. MSLs exist to connect the science and clinical research with the clinical practice, ensuring that the right data, the right evidence, and the right insights reach the right people at the right time. The MSL role emerged years ago when the pharmaceutical industry realized that the traditional sales representatives could no longer handle increasingly complex scientific discussions. From small molecules to biologics, from gene therapy and immuno-oncology, the conversations required is a much deeper level of science and expertise. By that time, the big pharmaceutical organizations started to hire physicians or MDs and pharmacists, not as sales professionals, but as scientific experts, medical peers, strategic partners to healthcare professionals. So, here, when we talk about MSLs, we are not talking about a commercial or a sales job. We are talking about scientific experts who can educate, inform, and listen. Like all the roles in medical affairs, MSLs has no sales targets in the pharmaceutical industry. This is important. And actually, they work completely independent from the commercial strategies. MSLs ensure that medical community understands the clinical value of the new therapies. And at the same time, they bring back the real-world insights that help shape the medical strategy in their organizations. In other words, MSLs operate at the intersection of science, strategy, and communication. Now let's go through the main pillars of the MSL job description, or in other words, the roles and responsibilities of MSLs. And we will not go into bullet points, but we will try to dig deeper in each of them. On top of the list is the scientific exchange and education. MSLs engage in peer-to-peer scientific discussions with physicians, researchers, healthcare decision makers, regulators. The word peer-to-peer relationships here is very important because you have to understand that the relationship between MSLs and the external stakeholders or key opinion leaders is based on mutual benefits and respect. The MSL provide them with science and data, and they provide you back with insights. MSLs translate complex clinical data into meaningful practice knowledge that supports evidence-based decisions. For example, when a new indication is approved, the MSL can explain not only the trial results, but also what those results mean for specific patient population, or how these results compare to the current standard of care. MSLs are also responsible for delivering scientific presentations, facilitating advisory board discussions, CME and speaker programs, as well as different types of educational sessions, ensuring that the science is understood, trusted, and applied responsibly. And as we mentioned before, the scientific exchange between MSLs and key opinion leaders is not one-way communication. True scientific engagement means listening as much as speaking. The best MSLs know how to capture medical insights. And when you talk about medical insights, these are the observations, questions, and feedback from the field. They can later inform clinical development, real-world evidence plans, or even access strategies. The second important responsibility of an MSL is the key opinion leader engagement and relationship building. MSLs build long-term trust-based relationships with key opinion leaders and thought leaders in their therapeutic area. This is about creating partnerships where both sides exchange value, scientific knowledge, for clinical perspective. For instance, a key opinion leader might share early clinical experiences with a new therapy, and the MSL ensures those insights from the key opinion leader will reach the global medical team, for example. Or the MSL might identify an emerging expert in a specific therapeutic area whose work aligns with the company research strategies. And this by itself is an insight that can help in shaping future research opportunities. Strong relationships of any MSL are the foundation of external medical engagement strategy, and they also play a very important role for the growth and development in medical affairs. If you ask me to name one key reason behind my success as an MSL years ago, I would confidently say it was my ability to build and maintain strong, trusted relationships with key opinion leaders and decision makers. These strong relationships are not built overnight. They take time, and they are built through credibility, consistency, and scientific integrity. Another important responsibility of MSLs is generating and sharing medical insights. In fact, this is a huge part of the MSL's contribution to the industry and to the clinical practice. And when we mention medical insights, these are the real-world observations that no data source can provide. MSLs gather insights mainly during field engagements, where they can listen and engage with attention to what key opinion leaders are saying. What challenges do they face in patient management? What barriers prevent the adoption of new medications? What emerging trends are changing the medical decisions? These are insights that are very important for the industry. And these insights, when properly documented and analyzed, they become the strategic intelligence of the medical organization, helping to guide medical plans, publications, clinical trial design. Moreover, these insights can help to shape the overall organizational strategy in certain therapeutic areas. Of course, there is a detailed process of gathering and analyzing medical insights, which we can definitely discuss in future episodes. The fourth key responsibility of MSLs is supporting clinical research and evidence generation. MSLs can definitely play a key role in supporting clinical trials, investigator-initiated studies, real-world data generation, and they often collaborate with clinical operation teams and medical and regional teams, global teams, to identify potential sites, investigators, and patient populations. Additionally, they help to ensure that the trial data is understood, contextualized, and ethically communicated once available. And as said before, MSLs also bridge the gap between clinical data and real-world application in clinical practice. For example, they may explain study endpoints to clinicians or help interpret findings in a balanced, compliant manner. This function strengthens the credibility of both the data and the organization. showing that evidence is understood and translated into better care. One of the most important responsibilities of MSLs is the cross-functional collaboration. Inside the pharmaceutical industry, MSLs collaborate closely with multiple functions, from medical affairs and clinical development to market access, regulatory affairs, and marketing teams. But the role remains strictly non-promotional. And as mentioned before, they work under policies called medical independency, where medical affairs decisions and initiatives cannot be influenced by commercial teams or strategists. Of course, medical independence is a big topic that we can discuss in future episodes as well. So, MSLs provide scientific guidance and ensure that all internal strategies are aligned with the latest medical evidence and ethical standards. Additionally, MSLs might help the access team, for example, to understand the clinical outcomes that are relevant to payer discussions, or support the brand team in reviewing the scientific accuracy of the materials. They are, in essence, the voice of science within the organization. In this context, there is also an administrative part of the MSL role and other medical affairs teams as well, including the review and approval of almost everything that goes out of the organization, including promotional materials, labels, and many other documentations. The objective of this reviewal process is to ensure that medical data and science are cited accurately and in a balanced and scientific way. So, ladies and gentlemen, these were the five main categories of the MSL's roles and responsibilities. Now, let's discuss the qualifications and skills that you need to have in order to be an MSL. First, we have to know that MSLs come from advanced scientific or clinical backgrounds. PharmD, MD, PhD. These are common qualifications because the role requires deep understanding of complex science and clinical practice. But academic knowledge is not enough alone. The true success factors lie in the blend of scientific acumen and interpersonal intelligence. So let's explore a few key skills that are needed. As mentioned, scientific expertise. And this includes deep understanding of the therapeutic area, mechanisms of action, clinical data, and evolving science in general. Two, business acumen, which can be built by practice. Three, strategic thinking and planning. This is very important as it is critical in recognizing patterns and insights and connecting them to the company objectives and strategies. Advanced communication and storytelling skills, with the ability to simplify complex concepts without losing the scientific accuracy. Emotional intelligence, because building trust with external experts and internal stakeholders requires empathy, listening, and professionalism. Compliance awareness, as you will be operating under strict ethical and regulatory frameworks, knowing what can and what cannot be discussed or done. So it's clear that successful MSLs don't just speak science. Actually, they connect science with strategy and people. So, my friends, the MSL role is evolving rapidly. With the rise of digital tools, real-world evidence, and omnichannel engagement, the field landscape has changed. MSLs today are not limited to face-to-face meetings. They engage through virtual channels, webinars, digital platforms, and this expands their reach and influence. They are also increasingly involved in data interpretation and analysis, using analytics to understand treatment patterns and outcomes from real-world sources. And in many organizations, MSLs now contribute directly to strategic planning, shaping medical strategy, identifying research priorities, and supporting access discussions through scientific storytelling, or what you can call data storytelling. The modern MSL is no longer just a field-based expert. They are becoming strategic medical experts who can influence healthcare ecosystems. The role is very important because healthcare is complex, and every decision from prescribing therapy to funding study depends on credible, unbiased, and scientifically grounded information. MSLs are the guardians of this credibility. They ensure that data is communicated with accuracy and ethics. They help the clinicians to make evidence-based decisions, and they bring back the insights to shape the future of medicine. That is to say, MSL transforms science into action, and that action can really save lives. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you are aspiring to be an MSL or heading a team of MSLs, remember this. What defines an MSL is not how many visits they complete or how many slides they present. It's how effectively they turn the science into understanding, understanding into impact. Thank you so much for your attention. I'll be happy to receive your comments and remarks. And let's keep this discussion going. See you next time.